Hey friends, it's Samantha Thompson, Executive Director with 31, and I wanted to come to you and make my third video on recruiting or sponsoring tips and tricks. So if you haven't checked out videos number one and two, check out my YouTube channel and you can find those. So video one, we talked about goal setting, and video two, we talked about making a list. So you're probably wondering, what do I do with this list? So now that you have your list made of anyone who might be interested in your business or who you want to work with or who you think could use your business in their life, you're gonna go ahead and contact them. So I recommend that you contact them by their preferred method. So if they prefer to communicate text, then you text them. If they prefer a phone call, do that. Email, Facebook message, whatever it is that they prefer. And you're just gonna say something simple to them, like, "Hey Mary, I'm really enjoying my XYZ business and I think you would be great at it. Would it be okay if I drop some information in the mail to you?" That's it. Simple. Keep it short, sweet, and to the point. Don't get into all the details of your company. This is where you can send the information to them so that they can look it over. Really easy to do, and then do that. Send them the information. So if you need to get 10 packets ready to go, ready to mail out with postage and everything, and that just need addressed before you contact people, do it. Because the key here is to make sure that you are following up. If you get yeses and then you don't mail anything for a week, you've kind of blown it at that point because you've lost the excitement. I'm not saying you can't do that, but I would definitely mail the things the day that you speak to people. So, get whatever it is that your company has for business opportunity information together. And then the other thing I would recommend you do is to make a why letter. So, for my company, we talk about why did you join 31 or what is your why? Why are you doing this? For your company, it may be something different. But basically, this is a letter. Make sure your picture is on there. People like that. You'll notice realtors always have pictures on their business cards because people are less likely to throw it away with a picture on there. So put your picture on there and then just explain why you joined the company that you joined, why you believe in them, and what that company has done to change your life, whether that's you've gotten out of debt, or you're able to send your son, little Johnny, to soccer or baseball lessons, or whatever it is that you're able to do because of your business. No matter how big or large, people want to hear that. And that helps them get to know you and get to know why you're doing the company that you are. So if you're in health and fitness, talk about what your health was like before and what it is after since you've joined. If you're into beauty and makeup, maybe you're going to talk about how it brought back all this confidence in your life and you feel beautiful to your husband again. If you're in skincare products or all natural products, maybe you're going to talk about that. If you're into essential oils, maybe you're going to talk about what you like to use your oils for or what they've done for you. And definitely talk about the income. You'll hear people say if you're not talking about money all the time, you're not talking about enough. That's a Sherry Hudspeth quote. And she's correct. You know, people don't know what you can make in direct sales. So make sure on your white letter you say something about your income as well. And don't be afraid of how big or how small that is. There's a statistic I've read one time that said something about people who just had an extra $300 or $400 would be able to stay out of foreclosure, would be able to keep their marriage together, would be able to do more for their children. So don't feel like, well, I'm only making $200 a month or $100 a month, no one cares about that. It's not true. Those dollar amounts can really change people's lives. And if you don't believe me, walk up and hand somebody $100 and see if they want to give it back to you or if they want to keep it. So, your second or your third tip, rather, is to make a letter and then put together your packets of opportunity information and then start contacting the people on your list and ask them if you can send them the information. That's all you got to do. Just ask if they want the information. Then you mail it out to them. And then watch my fourth video for what you need to do next. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.